call me Zo.
And I'm Dominique van Harst, but you can call me Do.
And welcome to Darizona. We're from the Netherlands, and we have been in Flagstaff for the last 2 weeks, and we have been exploring the adventures northern Arizona has to offer. We have found 4 different extreme sports, including rafting, an extreme adventure course, rock climbing, and mountain biking. And we dare you to try one of these out for yourself.
Now, you might be wondering why on earth we're wearing a life vest. Maybe you find this perfectly normal, but in case you don't, we're wearing these because our first adventure is about rafting.
Not just on any river, though. Here in Arizona, you can go rafting through the Grand Canyon, which I bet is pretty extreme.
Our reporter, Eliana Kuiper, looks in rafting in the Grand Canyon. Let's see how those extreme rafting trips really are.
We're here at OARS Grand Canyon Rafting and Dory Adventures in Flagstaff, Arizona, where whitewater rafting is the adventure sport of choice. Commercial rafting didn't start until 1960, but nowadays there are many organizations in the northern Arizona area that organize these rafting trips. Almost anyone can join, but there are always certain safety precautions involved. Let's take a look inside and see what it takes to prepare for a 2-week-long rafting trip.
OARS is one of the many rafting organizations in the rafting business that organize week-long or sometimes longer trips. What many people don't realize is that it takes a lot of preparation and work to go on a trip like this. Lou Steiger, a tour guide for OARS, says it takes at least 2 days before leaving to prepare.
Getting ready to do any kind of river trip in the Grand Canyon, particularly a 2-week one or 3-week one, is quite an undertaking. 2 days that you spend before a trip just getting ready for it, and a day that you spend after the trip just cleaning up. And we have a full-time food packer. She understands all the quantities and stuff like that. It takes her about a half a day to pack a whole river trip. That alone saves us an enormous amount of time. If we didn't have her packing the food and we didn't have a full-time staff here that kind of knew exactly what equipment is needed and stuff, it would take us 2 full days just to get everything organized, get it ready, and get it on the truck and ready to go.
Typically, besides the preparation, it takes quite a drive to get to the actual starting point of the trip. When all the gear is checked and loaded, the OARS crew heads over to Lee's Ferry or any of the other starting points in the Grand Canyon to set up the day before the trip starts. Once at the starting point, the crew readies the rafts and unloads all the supplies from the truck. When everything is ready, the crew will camp in tents on the rafts until their tourists arrive the next day. Whatever your reasons for going on a rafting trip, the beautiful scenery certainly has to be one of them. The Grand Canyon is one of nature's wonders, and rafting can bring you to its hidden depths. And it can allow you to explore the canyon and the river in a way that standing over the rim just can't bring you. Of course, there are a number of reasons for taking on this adventurous sport. The sense of excitement and the rush of adrenaline are like no other. Meeting like-minded enthusiasts is always a great experience. And Sean Browning, who's been along on about 90 rafting trips, says that every tour is exciting for all of the participants.
Well, when I take people on a tour, it's a lot of work, both for myself as a guide and for the people. They're getting to see one of the most beautiful places in the world. Like I said, it's very rewarding.
Sean Browning also says that each time he sees the Grand Canyon, it's a new experience. Tourists just need to keep having fun and enjoy the ride.
I always look forward to it, and I always see something new and have new experiences. It's a very large place, the Grand Canyon, and you could probably never see it all in your lifetime. So just being on the river, you see new things you've never seen before. And it's a great experience. Everybody should do it.
Rafting trips are available numerous times per year. In any case, all factors combined make for a beautiful and an unforgettable experience in the Grand Canyon.
If a 2-week trip sounds too long for you, 5-day and 7 to 8 day trips are also available for you to explore. However long you decide to go for, this adventure sport will certainly not disappoint. For Darizona, I am Eliana Kuiper.
Wow, that was amazing.
Yeah, I hadn't realized how much time and effort goes into preparing for a trip like that.
But I think it's definitely worth it, because have you seen those waves?
Yeah, well, next we're off to the extreme adventure course here in Flagstaff. Our reporter Shil Shahdari met up with some of the instructors there high up in the trees.
These people are also called rescue guides and safety patrollers. Entertainment and safety are the number one priorities at the adventure course.
So let's take a look at Darizona's next challenge.
Hi there, we're here at Flagstaff Extreme Adventure Course. At FlagX we have some exciting physical courses where people can test their limits. So, let's have a look at the course.
The course is broken up in 5 levels and each level is progressively harder. Each circuit is marked with a color-coded system indicating the challenge based on elevation and difficulty. You start at the green course, then the level of difficulty will work its way up from silver to blue to red and eventually the black course. We talked to Zach McDade, a manager at Flagstaff Extreme, who explained us that FlagX is special because there's nothing like the course anywhere in Arizona.
The goal of Flagstaff Extreme is to provide a safe, fun place to play where you can bring your family, challenge yourself, overcome fears because you get pretty high in the air, do something you're not comfortable with, but have a good, memorable experience to bring home with your friends and family.
Flagstaff Extreme has 5 adult courses and 1 kids course for kids between 7 and 11 years old.
We didn't want the parents just to come here and have the kids sit and be able to do nothing, so the little guys get to do the exact same obstacles that the adults do. The course is just lower to the ground and it's not quite as long as all of our courses.
The kids course will cost $25 plus taxes and fees for children ages 7 to 11. The course for children ages 12 to 15 that also have to be accompanied by an adult costs $49 plus taxes and fees.
You can provide facilitation, like team building exercises. For large corporate groups, we can do birthday parties, bachelorette parties, and we have drinks and snacks and ice cream available.
So we're here at the start of the adult adventure course. Only 20% of the people actually finish the 5 courses. So let's start.
When you're going through the adventure course, you will be escorted by a member of the Flagstaff Extreme staff. This team consists of 40 people with rescue guides and safety patrollers, which makes the course safe and fun for visitors of every level of competency.
The safety patrollers are kind of like our extra eyes in the sky, making sure customers are following the rules and making sure everyone's comfortable and safe. The rescue guides, we're running around, we carry a lot of extra gear, and we have to go through a lot of extra training because we actually got to get people down from the course. So even if someone's like 60 feet high, we can get from the ground to them in about 3 minutes, and then we hook them up to a rope and get them on the ground.
It doesn't matter what your ability or your health level is at Flagstaff Extreme. As long as you have determination and ask questions to the guides, you will definitely make it through the course.
What's great at Flagstaff Extreme is 99.9% of our customers are happy. They're doing stuff that they've never done before, learning new things, challenging themselves. So, it's a really good atmosphere to work in.
The course is open from 9 to 5 through the year. Only during certain extreme weather conditions such as lightning, strong wind and temperature below 22 degrees, they are forced to close.
For Darizona, I'm Cheryl Shahidari.
As you can see, the atmosphere at Flagstaff Extreme is always good. You can meet a lot of nice people there and have an amazing time.
Now, for those of you who are not very fond of heights, unfortunately, we're not going back to solid ground just yet. Our next adventure is about rock climbing, but first, it's
Fun Fact Time!
Which one of the following is of the popular climbing areas in northern Arizona? Is it A, Jurassic Park, which offers short, steep and slabby climbs, B, the Iron Cletch, which offers sport climbs at a high altitude, or C, the Pit, a limestone sport climbing area?
Pay close attention and you will find out the answer. Adventure reporter Ava Von Berta went to one of northern Arizona's most beautiful climbing areas.
We're here today at Paradise Forks, a popular climbing destination in northern Arizona. If you're looking for a nice workout, this would be a great place for you to spend your time. Because, well, let's face it, rock climbing definitely beats going for a run on a treadmill, doesn't it?
Paradise Forks is one of the many popular climbing destinations in northern Arizona, located only 45 minutes from downtown Flagstaff. The climbing is on basalt columns and the nature of the climbing is steep crack climbing. The area is in Sycamore Canyon at a point where the canyon is actually Y-shaped. It has 2 seasonal waterfalls which flow after the winter season. Climbing guide Jeff Snyder, who works at the Flagstaff Climbing Center, says climbers like to climb at Paradise Forks because of its strict traditional ethics.
If you're into traditional climbing, you could find a place like Paradise Forks, which is a really classic and well-known traditional climbing area.
However, in order to go climbing, you first have to take into consideration some safety regulations.
If you do decide that you want to climb on ropes, it could mean that you need to buy ropes and harnesses, as well as shoes and chalk, as well as seeking professional instruction so that you know what you're doing.
So what kind of gear do you use when you go climbing?
Some gear that you might see climbers using would be their climbing shoes, a harness,
okay,
some sort of device like this. This is called a belay device, and we use it to control the rope. And of course, your favorite lucky chalk bag. Do you want some? Nice. Nice.
Climbing in northern Arizona has become a popular sport because of its vast and varied landscape of forests, high elevation plains, and sculpted sandstone deserts. The main climate is a mountain climate, which is primarily found in northern and north-central Arizona, including Flagstaff and the Grand Canyon. During the summer, the temperatures can reach 80 degrees. In the winter, however, the temperature can drop to below freezing.
Weather in general can completely affect a climber and his potential climbs. For instance, if it starts raining or gets really, really windy or bad weather comes in, you might not be able to get outside and climb at all.
One of the many reasons why rock climbing has become such a popular sport is because of the thrill of climbing, or so says climber Jared Fritz.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. I liked it. There's just kind of a thrill to it, I guess, because of just the heights and just it's something that you don't do all the time. It's a lot of fun.
Now behind me, you can see what would be considered an advanced climbing area. To climb to the top takes a large amount of experience, ability, and above all, courage. The type of climb one chooses to do usually depends on the climber's ability and experience. However, the most important aspect of the climbing level is the climber's mental skills. The ability to overcome fear is the most important skill a climber can possess.
It's mental. You're constantly having to deal with your own worst enemies in your head and breaking through in order to become the best climber that you can be.
Rock climbing is an incredibly popular sport here in northern Arizona because of the beautiful vistas and amazing climbing locations. Here in the Flagstaff area, there are many guided tours you can take to these climbing locations, such as the Pit, Paradise Forks, or Jack's Canyon. So don't hesitate to come check these beautiful places out. For Darizona, I'm Eva van Beurden.
Well, after seeing that, I'm glad that we are standing here on solid ground.
But did you pay close enough attention? Did you catch the answer? The answer is the Pit, one of the places our reporter Eva visited.
Luckily, our next adventure is going to stay on the ground. At least for most of the time. Let's look at mountain biking. The steep slopes of mountains of northern Arizona provide rough and challenging trails for both professional and amateuristic mountain bikers.
Sophie van Eyck talks with professional local biker Ryan Wright to find out how extreme mountain biking at the professional level really is.
Hi guys, we're here at Buffalo Park with Ryan Wright. And as you can see, he knows exactly what he's doing. So I'm going to ask him what I need to know in order to go on a mountain bike myself.
Ryan Wright is 21 years old and born and raised in Flagstaff. It didn't come as a surprise that Ryan got on a mountain bike on a young age, as all of his family and friends enjoyed the sport. He began motocrossing when he was 5 years old and later on got into mountain biking, which helps him with his training physically and mentally.
And I did downhill mountain biking, cross-country mountain biking, some mountain biking racing though sometimes. This is a great sport to get into, really healthy. It makes you healthy. This is my first year being professionally onto a team though, and I raced semi-pro and previously, and just a great experience to be back though where I was at though before and racing pro and met great friends and stuff though, and it's just a great experience though, to have in my life, and I'm looking forward to the future in it.
Ryan bikes in Buffalo Park on a regular basis.
Buffalo Park is a beautiful place to ride. It's a great place to train. This atmosphere out here is just terrific. So it's a great place to ride and a great place to learn if you're a beginner or a professional. Come out here and just have fun.
Buffalo Park offers a 2-mile hiking loop trail, a picnic area, and great wildlife.
So Ryan, you did a great job out there.
Thank you.
Where do you think I should begin with mountain biking myself?
First off, you want to get your right bike. Don't ride a road bike out here like I'm doing, because it's not safe. And I lost my other bike in Phoenix, so that made it work out. So get a good bike on it though. Get the proper gear, helmet, gloves, protect your noggin and protect your hands. So that's all you really need for mountain biking.
Ryan advised me to go to the Absolute Bike Store, which I heard sells everything a mountain biker needs. The manager of Absolute Bikes is Anthony Quintile, a mountain biker himself. He's going to help me gear up and prepare for my first mountain biking trip.
If you're just beginning with mountain biking, we recommend at least having a helmet and gloves. I think that's very important. If you do fall down, you're apt to fall on your hand. And if obviously, you know, hitting your head can be a pretty substantial injury. So that would be the kind of gear you should have, aside from obviously a good mountain bike with, I would suggest, at least front suspension.
Okay, I changed, I got my bike, and the weather isn't really great, but I think I'm going to hop on my bike and see what it's all about. We're here at the Urban Trail System, which I heard is a great trail for beginning bikers. I'm really excited to explore the area, so let's go.
The Urban Trail System is great for beginners. Slopes there aren't very steep and rocky, which makes cycling easy, but because of the perfect surroundings, it's still adventurous. Make sure you bring enough water, because even when your trail is easy, you will need a good break during your mountain bike adventure. And although I forgot my gloves, it's important to wear the right gear. For more information about different trails in Flagstaff, visit one of the many bike stores downtown.
I just finished the trail, which was a lot of fun. So if you're a beginner just like me, you could give the Urban Trail System a try. But if you're a bit more advanced, you could go to the Buffalo Park. Now I'm going to get a coffee here at Kickstand, which is a meeting place for mountain bikers. For Darizona, I'm Sophie van Eyck.
As you can see, Flagstaff is the right place for a sport like mountain biking. There are a lot of different areas to ride your bike and explore, and Sophie, that water must have tasted really good after mountain biking.
Now we've seen some of the exciting and daring sports that Northern Arizona has to offer. The thrill of rafting, the challenge of the extreme adventure course, the heights of rock climbing, and the speed of mountain biking.
Now we dare you to try one of these out for yourself.
From NAU, thanks for joining us today on Darizona. I'm Zoe.
And I'm Doe.
Goodbye.
Trick, messing with my mind, I wake up.